Hello friends, today we will start with the next lecture in computer graphics. The course name is computer graphics and the code is CS351 and it is 302, and today we will start with the 2D transformations and matrices. In this particular unit, we shall be covering all the fundamentals of 2D transformation along with a few examples. We shall illustrate the basic facts of 2D transformation. Now basically the 2D transformation is based on the concept of matrices, and this particular slide shows the representation of a matrix A which is 3 cross 3 and each element is named appropriately as A11, A12 and so on, and it can be accessed in that way. And matrix is a rectangular array of numbers. A general matrix will represent any uppercase italicized letter. The element of the ith row and jth column is denoted by aij. This is the most important point that you have to note down here. Aij, we represent it with aij. And we start with indexing at I is equals to 1, and whereas it goes, c index is away from 0. So let us take another slide. In this we will see that addition process Cij is equal to Aij plus Bij. It means that element by element addition process is taking place here. This is already discussed in the linear algebra classes which we have already done in the mathematics paper. We are just revising the things so that when you are programming, you will find it handy to refer to the material. If you see here, there is a matrix A, a matrix B, and the resulting matrix C is there, and which shows the summation of information or data element by element in a matrix. Now let's say that we are able to see here, it is the multiplication process here, and in this multiplication process Cij is equals to k is equals to 1 to n aik bkj, that is ith row jth element. That is, we will multiply the matrices in a specific order that we can see from the next example here. Now in this particular example, if we see that this is matrix A and this is matrix B, we want to multiply. This is the ith row and this is the jth column. And similarly, we will multiply here. Similarly, we will do it here, and then here, and then here, and this is the final result here. And one of the intermediate results is shown here, and you can see that it is 2 into 6, 6 into 3, 7 into 2, which comes about 44. This is the first result of the multiplication process. Now this multiplication process, you already know that this is a 2 cross 2 matrix and this is a 3 cross 2 matrix, but this will not work because this and this should match, that is the column of the first one and the row of the second one should match, then only the multiplication process can take place. Now next let us see the next thing, that is matrix basis. AB is not equals to BA, that is the multiplication process of matrices A into B is not the same as B into A. And here matrix multiplication is distributive in nature, that is A B plus C is equal to A B plus A C. And here further we are seeing the transpose of the matrix here, and see here the elements are like this, and when we transpose it, the rows becomes columns and the columns becomes rows. Now let us start with the actual topic today, that is the 2D transformation. Transformation is a process by which we are able to bring about any change in the object of our interest. Let us say we have here an object. This is an object here, and we can perform translation, rotation, scaling and shearing on the object. Now suppose what do we mean by translation? We will be dealing them with individually, one by one, all the transformations, but just to explain the diagram, I am explaining the things here. Now if you see the object here, we will perform translation operation. Translation means moving an object about a certain distance. For example, I am standing here in front of you, and now if I move a distance dx,
then this is added to my previous position. Now my new position will be the summation of the distance traveled from the original position. Now if you see this particular diagram here, this is the translation process. Now rotation means rotating the object in a specific direction with a particular angle. Now if you see here, this is the particular representation here. How we actually obtain this, we will see through the examples and the matrices. Scaling is to reduce the size, increase or decrease the size of the object here. Now shearing means bringing about a change in the object in certain direction. Say for example, this is the change in shear which is applied in x direction here. Now we will see them or we will handle them one by one in the next set of slides. Now let us start with the first one, that is called as the translation process or the translation or transformation. Now we can translate the points in the xy plane to new position. Now this is the most important thing here. Xy means the original position here. This is the original position. Now you want to bring about a change, that is you are presently here and you want to bring the object to this particular position. That is p dash, x dash, y dash. And move by a distance dx units parallel to the x axis and dy units parallel to the y axis. This is the dx and this is the dy units. Now how the actual set of coordinates can be calculated as x dash is equal to x plus dx, that is the x component, and y dash is equal to y plus dy. Similarly, in the matrix format, this above translational process can be represented as x dash y dash is equal to xy plus dx dy. Now what is happening here, the element by element addition will take place. This is called as translational matrix. Okay, and these are the translational components dx and dy. If you define, this is called as a translational matrix here. Now this can also be represented as p dash is equal to p plus t. Now if you see this particular diagram, this is another example of translational process. If you see here, this is xy, the point was lying here and you have made a translation by the translational value dx and dy. Now the point has gone to this position. Now let us see again further, let us take another example here. Pxy and dxy, these are the two things which are given to us. And now we want to calculate x dash is equal to x plus dx and y dash is equal to y plus dy. And in the matrix format, it can be represented here as we have seen in the previous slides also. Now in this particular case, in this particular example, we are given here a particular point P and D here. Now P is minus 3.7 and minus 4.1. And t is 7.1 and 8.2. Now in order to obtain the values of x dash and y dash, we will just add up the translational values to the original coordinate value. Now this is equal to x dash is equal to minus 3.7. This is this one plus this one, and this one and this one are added here as shown here. And the final values are this one. This is 3.4 and 4.1. This is called as the translational process. This is the one of the examples of translational process. Now you can also take up a few problems. Say suppose you are given a point P2, 4 and translational vector is also given to you. You find out the values of P dash. Then another example, 8.6, minus 1, P is 0.4 and minus 0.2. Find the value of P dash. Okay, then you can find out the value of P. P is given here 0, 0 and P is given as 1, 0. Then you can find out the value of P dash here. Now, let us take another example in the case of translational process. In the case of translational process, if you see, you have drawn an object on the x-axis and the coordinates are 0, 0 and this is 1.5 and 1.50. And similarly here 0, 1.5 and similarly other coordinates can be calculated. Now what we want to illustrate is the that process, that the translation is a process which brings about the change in the position of the object. For example, x mu is equal to x old plus dx, y mu is equal to y old plus dy. This is the example of translational process. That is, now what is the significance of this particular object? So we have different coordinates for this particular object. This coordinate value, and this coordinate value. These values are known to us. Then, if we want to bring about a change in this particular object, then we have to take this object from this location to this location, which means that each of the coordinate positions or its values will change. Therefore, all the new coordinate values can be obtained by using this particular formula that we have already learned. Similarly, we can take up this triangle here. There is another problem here. We are given a triangle with coordinate values 1, 1, 3, 1, 2, 3 with the translational values tx is equal to 2, ty is equal to 3. And if we add these values to these coordinates, the triangle will move somewhere here in this region. Why I am saying in this region? Because it will become 3 and it will become 4. 3, 4 is this one. 3. And 4 here. Okay, so this is automatically going to change. Now let us take the next transformation, that is called as scaling. Now the points can be scaled or stretched by Sx along x-axis and Sy along the y-axis into the new points by the multiplication process. We can specify how much bigger or smaller by means of a scale factor. To double the size of an object, we use a scale factor 2. This is the most important part here, 2. And if we want to reduce the size of the object, we will have to multiply by a factor of 0.5. That is, it will reduce the size. Now, how will this scaling transformation take place? You have to calculate the new set of values for the coordinates, and which can be calculated by this particular formula. X dash is equal to SXX. That is, x was the old value, y was the old value of the coordinate, and now we multiply it by the components Sx and Sy. Similarly, these particular values can be represented in the matrix format as Sx 0, 0, Sy, x1, and y. This particular matrix is called as the scaling matrix, and as shown here, we can also represent it as P dash is equal to Sp. This is S and this is P, and this is P dash. Okay? So, this is called as scaling process. Now there are two definitions that we have to note down in scaling process here. Any positive numerical values can be assigned to the scaling factors Sx and Sy. Values less than 1 reduce the size of the objects. Values greater than 1 will produce an enlargement. Okay, so specifying a value of 1 for both Sx and Sy leaves the size of the objects unchanged. When both S and Sy are assigned the same values, we will have a uniform scaling is produced. Okay, there is some produced. Now, in the case of differential scaling, when the uneven values of Sx and Sy are given here, then it will result in differential scaling. Now, sometimes it may happen that we can control the location of the scale object by choosing the position called the fixed point. We can perform fixed point scaling also. Now, fixed point scaling, we will have a coordinate of the fixed point as xf and yf, and we can find out the new sets of points according to the fixed point as x dash is equal to xf, x minus xf, sx, y dash is equal to yf, y minus yf. So now xf and yf are the fixed points which you will have to be give, which will be given to you, and then according to the fixed point you will have to calculate the new values of the coordinates. Now this sx and sy values are the scaling parameters that will also be given to you. So x dash and y dash are the new values of the coordinate. Now let us see in the next slide the problem set. Now, we are given a point Pxy, and we are also given the scaling parameters Sx and Sy. Now, we want to perform the scaling process, that is x dash is equal to Sxx and y dash is equal to Syy, which can be represented as P dash is equal to Sp here. Now, if we see this particular example here, we are given a point PE 1.4, 2.2 and S3, 3. And here it is x dash will become, because we are multiplying this 1.4 with 3 and this 2.2 with 3 here, you can see there, and the final result is represented here. So this way, what we are doing, we are multiplying the matrices by some scaling parameters, and then we are performing a scaling task. Now in this particular example, if you see here, we are given an object here and we want to perform scaling here. Now if you see here, x nu is equal to sx into x old, y nu is equal to sy into y old. These are the old values of the coordinate positions, and sx and xy are the scaling parameters. Now this object gets enlarged. We can take up another example here. In this particular example, if we see here, we are given a triangle here and the coordinates are this one, and you can always apply the values of sx and sy to obtain the new size of the this triangle will change. Now let us take the rotational transformation, and which can be demonstrated with the help of a particular diagram which we can see here. This particular diagram is very, very essential here. This is the original position, that is Pxy, and new position is P dash x dash y dash. Now point Pxy is making an angle of alpha with the x axis, and angle P dash x dash y is making an angle of theta with this particular line L. Okay, so this total angle is theta plus alpha, and the position, original position was P, and the final position is P dash. Now we want to find out the values of the new coordinates. Now how to find out the values of new coordinates? First of all, we have to note down that the points can be rotated by an angle theta. Therefore, OP dash is equal to OP, this one. This OP dash and OP and OP dash are equal to L value. X dash is equal to OP dash cos alpha plus theta, okay, and which can be written as, because we know OP dash is equal to L, we have written cos theta plus alpha. If we open this cos A plus B term, then we can write down cos A cos B sin A sin B. This is the sign here, so we can write down it is equal to X cos theta and minus Y sin theta here. Similarly, we can find out the values of y coordinates, and which can be represented as OP dash sine alpha plus theta, where OP dash is L, L sine alpha plus theta. We know sine A plus B, and which is equal to cos A sine B plus sine A cos B, which can be represented as x sine theta y cos theta. In the matrix format, this particular equational representation can be done in this way. This is equal to cos theta minus sin theta cos theta x y, which is written as P dash is equal to RB. This is the rotational transformation with respect to any object. So we can find out the coordinates. If we rotate an object, we can find out the new coordinate values. Now suppose we are given an object here. You can see that the value of theta is 5/6. Original position was this one, but it has moved to this particular location. We can always find out the values of the coordinates by putting the value of 5/6 here by cos 5/6, by sine 5/6, sine 5/6, cos 5/6, and the old values of the coordinates are already known to us. And then we can redraw the object again. Now this is most essential point here. We have to note down, this is the rotation of a point about an arbitrary pivot position. Say suppose we have a point XR, YR, then we can find out the rotation with respect to that particular point as represented here. This is XR and YR, this is the pivot point, and X minus XR cos theta, Y minus YR sin theta, YR plus X minus XR sin theta, Y minus YR cos theta. This is the representation of this is the representation of the points to calculate the values of the coordinates in the case of pivot point. Now we can see the diagram here, and we can see that this particular thing, XR, YR, is this particular point, which is away from the origin, and this original point was XY, and it has gone up to X dash, Y dash. So it can be represented here. Now we can review the things again. Translation is a process by which we add the translational parameters. It becomes P dash is equal to P plus P. Similarly, your scaling parameters, P dash is equal to SP, and your rotational transformation can be brought about by P dash is equal to RP. The process of the 2D transformation that we have already done can be changed or modified with the help of homogeneous coordinate system, multiplying versus adding matrix. Ideally, all the transformations would be the same, easier to code. Now, if you represent it in the homogeneous coordinate system, we will have to add another point into it, and that we can see here. For a given 2D coordinate, we have 2D coordinate x, y, we will introduce a third dimensional x, y, and 1. In general, homogeneous coordinate system can be represented as x, y, w. Two homogeneous coordinates, x, y, w, x dash, y dash, w, are said to be same or equivalent if x is equal to kx dash, y is equal to ky dash, w is equal to kw. So, we can therefore x, y, w can be normalized by dividing the element by 1. Generally, the value of w is kept as 1. Therefore, the new coordinates that will become will be x, y, comma 1. In the case of homogeneous coordinate system, xx, yh and h, the homogeneous parameter h is a non-zero value, we can represent it as x is equal to xh upon h. Same. Y dash is equal to yh upon m. Generally, the value of h or w, whatever the previous slide that we have also seen, it is w or h is the same. Here, x value will be 1. So, this is shown here, x, y, comma 1 here. Now, in the case of homogeneous transformation, the translation of a point by dx and dy can be represented as 1, 0, dx, 0, 1, dy, 0, 0, 1. Now, in order to calculate the value of representation of a point in homogeneous column vector, we perform the calculation as this is the translational matrix and this is the coordinate matrix, that is the columnar coordinate matrix. Now, what we are doing, we are multiplying this with this, this with this, and this with this, which is shown here 1 into x, this, this 1 into x, 0 into y, dx into 1, this is here. Then 0 into x and 1 into y and dy into 1, which is shown here. And similarly, 0 into x and 0 into y, 1 into 1, which is shown here. And we get the result as x plus dx, y plus dy and 1, which is equal to the translational process that we have already learned. Now, if we see here, matrix multiplication. In the case of matrix multiplication, that is what we have already done. Matrix multiplication, the element by element multiplication is there. Ax, by, cz, dy, cz, dx, ey, fz, dx, ey, fz, gx, hy, iz. It is there. This is the multiplication process that is very essential. We have to keep track of this particular thing. Now, in the case of homogeneous transformation, the translational process can be represented as this. We have already discussed the translational process is equal to translational matrix multiplied by the coordinate matrix, which is generating the final new values of the coordinates as x plus dx, y plus dy, 1, and which can be written as t dx, y, v. Similarly, we can bring about a change in the scaling process, scaling transformations as well. The scaling translations in the homogeneous coordinate system are represented as SX00, 0, SY0, 0, 0, 1, and which will be multiplied by the coordinate values, and we can write it here SX, X, SY, Y, and 1 into 1. So we get here SXX, SY, and 1. So this is the homogeneous coordinate system representation for translation and scaling. Now we can see here the rotation process. Already we have the rotational matrix is known to us, and cos theta minus sin theta 0, sin theta cos theta 0, 0, 0, 1, we can multiply it this way. So what happens here in this case, cos theta x minus sin theta y 0 into 1, so it becomes 0 here, and sin theta x cos theta y 0 into 1 is 0, and here it can be represented as 0, 0 and 1, and similarly just we have put a 1 here, which means the same thing here. So we can represent this. So In the next case, inverse transformation. Suppose you have already performed a translation or a rotation, or you have already performed scaling operation, or you have generally performed the transformation process on an object. Now you want to bring about the change in the object by retransferring it back to the original location. So how can you do that? This can be done with the help of inverse transformation. Inverse transformation is a process by which you reverse the effects of the transformations that have already been done. 1, 0, minus dx, 0, 1, minus dy, 0, 0, 1. So here, earlier it was dx and dy here, but if you put negative here, if the effect of the translational matrix is subtracted from the value. Now you can see the inverse translation, which can be represented by inverse translation matrix, 1, 0, minus dx, 0, 1, minus dy, 0, 0, 1. Similarly, the inverse rotation can also be expressed, cos theta, sin theta, 0, minus sin theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, and 1. Similarly, you can represent the scaling transformation and inverse scaling transformation, 1 by sx, 0, 0. 0, 1 by SY, 0, 0, 0, 1 here. So, this way you can bring about the change that has been already done. You can bring you can remove those changes from the object. Now, there is another concept that is very interesting and very useful for you for performing the application of 2D transformations to the objects. Now, this particular thing is called as combining the transformations. Suppose you want to bring about two or three transformations together on an object, though then this type of concept is called as combining the transformations. And a number of the definition particularly says a number of transformations can be combined into one matrix to make the things easy. Because earlier, suppose you want to perform first of all translation, then rotation, then scaling, individually multiplying the matrices will lead to time consuming process. Maybe sometimes you may create an error, but what happens, suppose you are creating a combined matrix and then multiplying the things, I think that will save your time, and this we can be combined into one matrix to make the things easy. Allowed by the fact that we use homogeneous coordinate system. First of all, we have to use the homogeneous coordinate system. Imagine rotating a polygon around a point other than the origin, transform to center point to the origin, rotate around the origin and transform back into the center. Suppose you have got an object which is not presently on the origin. So what we will try to do, that these are the three points, that is transform the center point to the origin. Say for example you are given a triangle, then the centroid is to be transferred to the origin and then rotate the object around that point, the degree of value that is being given here. Then you have to take the object back to its own original location. Now if you see this particular diagram, it will make the things more clear to you. Now if you see this particular diagram here, you can see that there is a house here in the first coordinate, which is say suppose centroid is here, it is not lying in the origin. Now what happens, we will bring about this particular point here as shown here, that is t dx by dy h. And then we will rotate it, perform the rotational transformation, and then we will take the object back to its original location. Therefore, we are performing inverse r theta and t dxy to the particular object which is called as house. House has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points here in this particular object. So this particular object will be, first of all, we will multiply, we will get this particular matrix, and then we will multiply the individual coordinates with this particular matrix values to get the final position of the object. Now we can see the combining transformation effect here, which is represented as here. Now this is the inverse translation, which is represented as 1, 0, minus dx, 0, 1, minus dy, 0, 0, 1. And here cos theta minus sin theta 0, because we are performing r theta, sin theta, cos theta 0, 0, 0, 1. And this is the translational matrix, which is given as 1, 0 dx and 0, 1 dy, 0, 0, 1. X, y, comma 1 is the old coordinate values of the particular object that of the interest. which is represented as v dash is equal to d dx minus dx minus dy r theta e d dx y. Remember that this particular process is very dependent upon the how the matrix multiplication takes place. So it is very, your results may vary here. So let us see this particular example here. You can note down these examples for your exercise purpose. Now we are given, we have to translate this object by 7, 2. This is the object here. Now we have to translate each of the point using the translational matrix, and then we have to draw the final object here. In the exercise 2, we are given an object here, and the scale, the shape of an object 3 in x, that is Sx is 3 and Sy is 2 here, because this is called as differential scaling here in this particular process. Now in the exercise 3, which you have to solve, in the particular exercise 3, there is an object here, you have to rotate it by an angle of 30 degree, which we have already discussed here, and you have to put the results in this. Similarly, now further in the homogeneous coordinate system, I want to further clarify a few things. The homogeneous coordinate system, we are just revising these slides again. This is your original method of doing the translation, but when we apply the homogeneous coordinate system, this way we represent the matrices. Similarly, this way we represent the scaling matrix, and this way we will represent the rotational matrix in the homogeneous coordinate system, as we have already discussed in the previous slides. Similarly, if we go further here, in the composite process here, additivity of successive translations. Say for example, if you want to perform translation 2 times, suppose I am standing here, my next position is this and my next position is this. That means I have performed the translation of myself twice. So how can I represent this? This can be represented as p double dash is equal to t dx2 dy2 p dash t dx2 dy2 t dx dy p. Here, this is the translational vector in the first case, and this is the translational vector in the second case. Now we have to multiply them together, and then in order to multiply, you can see here in this process, this is the first translational matrix, this is the first translational matrix, and this is the second translational matrix. When we multiply them together, we get 1, 0, dx1 plus dx2, 0, 1, dy1 plus dy2, 0, 0, 1. Ultimately, what is happening here, the x translational value is added with the another x translational value, and y translational value is added with the another y translational value, as shown here. And then we multiply with the coordinate value of that particular point. Now, if we see this particular example here, 2D transformations, we are having a point here, 2, 1, which was presently here, and examples of composite transformation, we want to bring about a change here in this particular point. So we have here, we'll 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and then we want to bring it back to its. That is, we have done this way. So we can see that this composite transformation is a process by which we can bring about combined effect of changes in the particular objects of interest. Now if you see here, the next slide, multiplicativity of successive scalings. If we see this particular slide here, if we want to perform scaling 2 times to the same object, then what it can be represented as Sx2, Sy2, Sx1, Sy1 into P, which is represented here, scaling matrix 2 and scaling matrix 1. If we multiply them together, we get Sx2 into Sx1, 0, 0, and 0, Sy2, 0, Sy1, 0, 0, 0, 1 here. And if we want to perform rotation 2 times to the object here, r theta 2, r theta 1, p, r theta 2, r theta 1, p, this becomes r2, p, which is represented as r2, 1,
and you can see that this is the second rotational matrix and this is the first rotational matrix, and if we multiply it here and we get cos theta 2 plus theta 1, that is the summation of the angles, that is theta 1 and theta 2, minus sin theta 2 sin theta 1, 0, sin theta 2 sin theta 1, cos theta 2 plus theta 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 here. So we can represent them, if we want to perform rotation two times, it is the summation of the all the angles that are available. So what happens in the case of composition transformations, we have different types of transformations. For example, we are performing rotation and then translation with the point. So r theta t dxy, r theta is your cos theta minus sin theta cos theta 0 0 1, and this is multiplied by 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, and then this is the net result here, and then individually you can multiply the coordinates with this particular value. So we can see some of the examples here. Let us see the object here in the previous case first. This one. If we see this particular triangle here, and we want to perform, since it is not lying at origin, t minus 1 rst, and therefore it is given here, rotate by 90 degree, uniform scaling 3x, both around the object center, not on the origin. So what happens here, this is the 1, 0, 3, 3 times, 0, 1, 3, 0, 0, 1, suppose the which is having a coordinate value which will bring this to the origin, and we want to perform, then translate the object to the origin first, scale, rotate and translate, that is scale, rotate and then translate it back to its own original position. So we are bringing it to the origin and then multiplying it. So cos theta, because we are rotating, we are given an angle 90 degree, cos 90 minus sin 90 0, sin 90 cos 90 0, 0, 0, 1. And we can perform uniform scaling, sx value is 3, 0, 0, 0, 3, y and 0, because we are given a uniform scaling, so therefore sx equal to sy here, and this is the translational matrix. Suppose we are in the we want to 1 0 minus 3 0 1 minus 3 0 0 1 here, so we multiply them together all these, and then we can find out the individual values of the coordinates. Now if you see this particular thing, we want to demonstrate that RT, if we change the order, say for example if we put the RT inverse ST, then it is going to create a problem for us. This is not going to be with the same results. So therefore order matters here. Similarly, considering the questions, we can find out how we can do that. This has already been discussed. Now, let us take another set of things. Yes. Let us do the shearing of objects. This is called as the shearing transformation. We can bring about a change in the object. Shearing enjoys the property that all the points along the given line L remain fixed, while the other points are shifted parallel to L by a distance that is proportional to their perpendicular distance from L. Note that shearing of an object in the plane does not change its area at all as a margin. Note, let us say that shearing can easily be generalized to the three dimension where planes are translated instead of lines. Now let us see the example here, how we can do the shearing. First of all, let us see this particular shearing concept. Shearing a point x by a factor hx along the x-axis and hy along yx is given by the following formula. X dash is equal to x plus hxy and y dash is equal to y plus hyx, which can be represented here as 1 hx 0 g hy 1 0 0 0 1 0, this xy 1. So we can find out the values of the shearing, we can find out the values of the coordinates after the performance of shearing on the object coordinates. Now, if you see here in this particular slide here, in this particular slide, the effect of shearing looks like pushing the object in the direction that is parallel to the coordinate. Now, suppose we are performing only shear in the x direction, so we can write down y dash is equal to y, x dash is equal to x plus hxy. If we are performing shear in only in the y direction, it is going to be y dash is equal to y dash plus x hx hyx, and x dash is equal to x here. So this way we can bring about a change. Now you can see this particular diagram here. Suppose this is a unit square 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. These are the coordinate values of the square. Now we want to have a shear SHX value 2. Suppose that is we are pulling it in this direction. So this is fixed and this is moving this way. So how can we represent it? This, the new values of coordinates will be this one. How we have calculated that depends upon the previous mechanism that we have learnt here. This is the previous mechanism. If we are just bringing about a change in x direction, or we are bringing about a shear in the y direction here. Now, in the next example, if you see here, we are bringing about a shear only in y direction, so we can perform this way and we will pull it this way and it will become something like this. So let us take the last topic of this particular lecture, which is the reflection process. Reflection is another transformation which can be brought about, and you can see that we see the mirror image of the objects here. Suppose we are given an original object here, in the x-axis, when along the line y is equal to 0, we will have this type of image form, and this can be represented in the transformation matrix as 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 1. And if we multiply individual coordinate values here, then we will get these coordinate values from this particular multiplication of this particular matrix here. Now if we see here in the next case, we see the reflection in this particular x is 0 and along y axis. So what happens here, the object is here, it will appear in this direction, and the matrix representation is minus 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, and the individual coordinates values are to be multiplied, and then we can find out the results, as we can see here in this particular diagram. And in this process of this is another example of representation of reflection about the origin. This is the object, original object is here, and we want to perform the reflection process, and we have to use this particular matrix, and we have to multiply, and we can find out the new set of coordinate values as this. So there is another thing that we have to do when we want to perform a reflection along the line y is equal to x. In this particular case, this is the original position 1, 2, 3 are the coordinate positions of the triangle here, and this is the matrix, this reflection matrix for which we have to multiply the coordinate values, and we can get the new object position as seen here in the diagram. If you see this one, and it is reflection along y is equal to minus x, and it is 1, 2, 3, this is the original object, and the new object will be formed here, and it can be obtained with the help of this particular example. As and this is the way we can get the reflection. So overall, what we have done in this particular process of reflection, we have tried to find out the reflection along
the x-axis when y is equal to 0, or along y-axis when x is 0, or along the or at the origin. And we have also calculated reflection along a line y is equal to x, and reflection along a line y is equal to minus x. All these formulas we have to remember, and these formulas will be helpful in calculating the numericals as well as in applying to the objects in the laboratory work. Now finally, we can see the laboratory work here. You have to draw the object in MATLAB, and then you have to perform the reflection process. You have to note down this particular thing. So here in today's lecture, we have done the 2D transformations, and in 2D transformations we have attempted the topics like translation, rotation and scaling. We have learned about the formulas that of 2D translation, rotation and scaling, and then we have converted the formulas into homogeneous coordinate system of representation. And we have learned that in the homogeneous coordinate system of representation, we have learned the translation process, we have learned the rotation process, we have learned the scaling process. And then we have performed the composite transformations on the objects also. Composite transformation means applying multiple transformations on the same object. So we multiply the individual matrices, and then we finally multiply with the object coordinates. And then we have done the shearing and the shearing and reflection transformations, which are the final topics of this particular 2D transformations. So this is all for 2D transformations.